Breaking news on the electricity crisis. State Treasurer Matt Keane has just fronted the cameras, urging every household across the state to reduce their energy consumption right now to avoid a blackout tonight. It comes just hours after the regulator suspended the energy market nationally for the very first time in a drastic move to keep the lights on.
The most powerful man in power seizes control of the market.
This decision was made because it was impossible to operate the system under current conditions.
At 2 o'clock this afternoon, the Australian energy market operator suspended the market that sets the price of power on the East Coast. Tonight, in this unprecedented emergency measure, the government operator dictating how much energy private generators should provide and the price they will be paid.
That is the best way for Australian homes and businesses to be sure that the lights will go on when they flick the switch.
But tonight, a warning for New South Wales. A number of power generators withdrawing their supply and threatening blackouts.
The Australian Energy Market Operator has asked people to consider their electricity usage tonight between 5:30pm and 8:30pm, where it's safe to do so.
This really does make us a laughingstock. I mean, I can't think of any kind of first world nation that has ever really done this. It's just, it's extraordinary.
And everything will soon cost more.
Conditions remain tight in the coming days, in particular in New South Wales, where we would urge consumers to conserve energy where it is safe to do so.
The best interests of consumers will always come first, and I'm simply saying that AEMO will have the government's support in any action that they choose necessary to take.
We shouldn't be in a situation where people feel like they have to turn off their heating or not cook their dinner because of the potential lack of supply of energy.
The operator says the decision was caused by a large number of generators being out of action, which is typical for shoulder seasons but not the start of winter. Planned transmission outages, periods of low wind and solar energy output, a number of ageing coal-fired power stations suffering breakdowns, and the early onset of cold weather increasing demand.
I think what we're seeing is very challenging times.
The problems compounded by demand peaking in the early evening when wind and solar power is least reliable and effective.
Tonight, major generators are in crisis talks trying to work out what this ruling means for their businesses and their future, with one saying, we're in uncharted waters.
In what world would the private sector ever willingly come into this market without an absolute underwrite from a government? Why would anyone come here and make those investments?
Our assets are all operating, but I think a little bit deeper to that is that we've got to be able to secure the fuel supply.
What we're doing is focused on making sure that we get through tonight.
Charles Croucher, Nine News.
Charles is with me in the studio. Charles, what happens now?
Well, Pete, those warnings in New South Wales specifically apply until 8:30pm tonight. This is being caused largely by coal-fired power stations in Queensland not producing energy as the market operator requested. We've not been told why, but this is the first test of these new rules, and there simply is no playbook for what happens next. The market operator's decision will be reviewed daily, and energy providers may still be compensated for any losses. Ultimately, that compensation would likely result in higher costs for consumers. A lot of uncertainty tonight, Pete, but one thing we do know is that markets hate uncertainty.
Indeed. Charles, thank you.